Hi there, it's Jami-Lee Ross, the MP for Botany, speaking to you again from Parliament. In this latest video update, I just want to share with you a couple of things that have been happening this week. Firstly, the Leakey Homes financial assistance package was passed by Parliament last night. Now, that package is going to provide assistance for people with leaky homes. Currently, at the moment, a lot of people are having to go through the legal system to try and get funding to repair their leaky homes. They're finding that frustrating and very time-consuming, and often the people that actually built the homes have folded, collapsed their businesses, and the last people standing having to foot the bill are councils. What the government's done is put in place a package which will mean that 25% of the cost of repair will come from the government, 25% will come from councils, and 50% will come through or funded by the people themselves, often through an arrangement that the government's worked out with banks. Now, this package is very good for leaky homeowners because it's been a real struggle to get the houses fixed, and a lot of people have told us, myself and the government, that they really don't want to go through a court system to get their homes fixed. They just want to get their homes fixed, and this package puts in place an option for them to take up to fast track getting their homes fixed so they can get back living in a nice lifestyle and away from the nightmares of having a leaky home. It's about $1 billion worth of government expenditure. It's been several years in the making, and I know the Honourable Maurice Williamson has put a lot of time and effort into this, and we're all really pleased that it's finally passed Parliament. Also this week, there were some big changes to ACC that were announced. The government's announced that the levies that people pay for ACC are going to be reducing. Employees' levies will be reducing by 17%, and employer levies will be reducing by 22%. A few years ago, the government had to increase levies because it was looking like ACC would have some very large deficits that we'd have to deal with. In the 2007-8 year, there was a $2.4 billion deficit, and in the 2008-9 year, there was a $4.8 billion deficit. Since National's been the government, we've been able to cut that right back. The ACC has been running in surplus since the government's been in office, since the National Party's been in office, and we're now at the point where improvements made to the system, increased rehabilitation rates, and less people needing long-term assistance through the ACC scheme has resulted in the government being able to announce reductions in ACC levies. This almost never happens, that reductions in levies take place, but it's been able to happen because the government's put in place policies to try and make ACC work better and to try and reduce the deficits that ACC has seen in the past under previous governments. So that's some really good news that's out there for people who are paying ACC levies. They're going to be getting some reductions. Last thing I want to mention is a campaign that the government's pushing right now. It's called the What's My Number campaign. It's about making sure people have the opportunity to look at how they're paying their power prices and whether there are other options out there for people to get alternative power suppliers, which may be cheaper. It's a website people can go to, What's My Number, and it's it gives you the ability to put in your details, see whether there are other options out there in your area for getting power prices, and seeing whether there are some savings you can make. I personally had a look myself, and it turns out there's about $150 a year that I could save by changing power companies, and I didn't even know that because I hadn't done the investigation work. This website's an easy opportunity for people to look at their own personal situation, whether there's the option to save some money on power prices. Only takes 2 minutes, and I'd really encourage people to look up the What's My Number campaign. Have a look at the website. You may be able to make some savings on your power prices. Thanks again. Nice to talk to you, and have a good day.